Hey everyone, good morning, afternoon, and evening. This is Lazy Link here. I'm going to be going ahead and making a series of YouTube videos, doing a Let's Play of the Star Wars The Old Republic. So it should be really fun, and we're going to go ahead and get started here, and we're going to make a new character. So let's go ahead and let's do that. So this is a free-to-play game, as many of you know, but also there is a subscription-based, not prescription, that is some other drugs that you probably need to get from your doctor, but this is definitely not from the doctor. So we're going to go ahead and create a new character here. Alright, so what shall we choose? Shall we choose to be the light or the dark side? That is interesting. So we could be the Galactic Republic, I'm sorry, and the Sith Empire. Well, let's go ahead and you know what I want to do? I think I want to go ahead and try out a bounty hunter class. They seem pretty good and sound pretty fun. So, you know, everyone wants to be a Jedi and everything, but let's make a bounty hunter class here. Mm-hmm. So let's do that. So male or female? Well, I play, you know, both male and female classes in any games that I play. So let's pick a let's do a male, and let's do like a cyborg. I think that would be pretty sweet. So let's go ahead and do that.
Just point me in the direction of the action.
Alright. So let's go all the way back down. His head, complexion, eye color, cybernetics, no hair, hair color, and skin color. Okay. So let's pick the body type first. So let's go ahead. So he's kind of skinny.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Nah, that doesn't sound like a bounty hunter to me. That seems pretty good too, right there.
I'm always a professional.
I bet you are. All right. Ooh, that's a bounty hunter right there. Ooh. And then ooh, that guy's been eating too much.
There's payment involved. I'm interested.
Donuts or whatever they eat in the Star Wars universe there. So I think I'm gonna get this tall guy. He's pretty sweet looking. So let's do different head here. Let's see what we got.
I'm interested.
All right. These are kind of interesting looking.
I'm always a professional.
Let's get a good jawline here. That's kind of a little rounded off there. I think that... Oh, he's got a little butt chin there. Alright, there we go. That's not too bad. So let's put some scars on this guy. It'd make him pretty awesome looking. Oh, yeah, he's seen a little too much action. He's got some burn marks. Oh,
there's payment involved. I'm interested.
What is he, the Joker's brother or something? Let's put a smile on that face. So,
just point me in the direction of the action.
All right. So he's got some scars. Let's make him like a robot, though. Maybe he lost his eyes in battle or something. Yeah, that one actually kind of covers both the eyes, so that could definitely be a legit way to go ahead and explain his story about losing his eyes. So complexion here, there's a lot of complexion. Let's see what we got.
Just point me in the direction of the action.
Got a little bit of hair there. Ooh, Some of these are interesting. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Kind of
point me in the direction of the action.
Reminds me just a little bit of Commander Shepard in Mass Effect. Yeah, that game's pretty fun too.
Just point me in the direction of the action.
I actually kind of like this one. I think I'm gonna go with that one. So eye color, of course, we don't need because he's gonna be using that. But I do want to check out the other cybernetics that he does have available to us. So what do we got? What's the difference between one and two there?
I'm always a professional.
You see that? I don't know. Huh.
I'm always a professional.
Okay, we know, sir. We know. So, okay. Got. Alrighty. Got on the side of the eyes. Kind of the side of the face with the eye.
I'm interested.
Maybe I should just do this instead of keep clicking on him because he keeps talking. So let's go ahead and maybe he's one eye. Well, that's kind of like that's pretty cool.
Their own rules.
Oh wow. Yeah, I think that one's pretty cool. So let's choose some hair. Well, I don't know. Some of these hair is kind of cool.
In the direction of the action.
I keep clicking on that thing. It's just a force of habit, playing other video games. Nah, he doesn't sound as cool, Bounty Hunter, with that kind of hair. Got like a mohawk with a little bit of the side there. Got a little bun in the back. Interesting. Mohawk with the little bun. We should totally do a mohawk on this guy. But we'll see. With some mutton chops. Look at that. Isn't that epic? Let's get through there.
Pleasure doing business with you.
That one's not bad. It's more military esque. Alright. There, get a little long hair. Nah. I think we're gonna go. I think the one I really liked was this one. He seems pretty cool with the short hair with little faux hawk kind of hairstyle. Let's go with hair color here. A little bit of red. Whoop, wrong button to hit there. Darker hair. Or should I make him a little bit? Let's make it. Let's do like a little bit of brown there. It looks like a little bit of reddish brown. That's pretty cool. Skin color. Look, he's been tanning, you know, outside. All right, there we go. I think we have made our Bounty Hunter male cyborg. He looks pretty sweet. So now is the hard part of the whole thing, is doing a name. So I'm going to try Lazy Link, but don't know if that will be available. Let's play. Oh, wow, look at that. All right, we have our character. So let's go ahead and see the beginning cut screen, or cut scene here. Thank you. Oh, I love when that Star Wars screen pops up. All right, let's get into it. Yeah, I remember when I first started playing this game back when it came out in 2011. It was really fun, but I only played it for about a couple of months or so, and then I stopped playing, and since Star Wars just came out not too long ago, last month, or I should say last year now, I'm back into Star Wars, so definitely want to play it again and experience this game. He looks pretty badass. Ooh, that guy did something that he wasn't supposed to. Maybe he's
set up. See if you can't get that security network running, Mako.
Sure thing, Brayden. We'll be... hey, now.
Indeed. The main attraction has arrived. Team, this is the man we're pinning all our hopes on. Best shot I've ever seen in nerves of steel. He's great hunt material, all right. What do you say, Hunter? Ready to meet your team?
All right. Let's go ahead and... I think I'm going to go ahead and be kind of more on the evil side. Just because bounty hunters are... Yeah, I don't know many bounty hunters that are nice. Not that I know any. But anyways, let's go ahead and let's make this guy pretty cool. So let's do, when do I get paid here?
What I'm ready to do is make a pile of credits.
A man from your same mold, Jory.
Bliska taka, ya yoska ukle yuga chesko pukuta.
Let's do things official-like. This is Mako, a little genius I picked up years ago in Nar Shaddaa. She provides intel and tech.
Hope you're as good as the old man says.
And the big bruiser is Jory. He handles the heavy lifting and provides security for our base of operations.
Atungi ma chechu, I kutsi nankihe.
Oh, alright, yeah. You know what? You two work for me. Yeah. Let's do that.
Just do your jobs and keep out of my way.
You're a real ray of sunshine, aren't you?
All right, enough introductions. Down to business. We're here because the Great Hunt has been called. Little Mako is the most rabid fan of hunter history this side of Geonosis. And even she doesn't know exactly what the Great Hunt entails.
I do know the names of every Great Hunt winner, though. Bloodworthy, the Defenestrator, Jewel and Nightbringer.
Every bounty hunter who's won a Great Hunt went on to massive glory and riches. Which is why we're here.
Alright, that's exactly what I want to hear.
What's our first move?
Here's what I know so far. The Great Hunt has two groups, the Mandalorian Elite and Freelance Bounty Hunters sponsored by influential crime lords. There's no time to make you a Mandalorian. That means you need a sponsor.
Nimro the Hutt runs this stinking little town. I've got just enough pull with that gangster to get you an introduction. Mako. Scan for every bounty in the area. I want the nastiest, most brutal, untouchable scum you can find.
I'm on it, Brayden. One nasty character coming up.
We need to get you situated as a big-time hunter, at least as far as the locals know. Then we contact Nimro. Mako will plant rumors about your off-world exploits. But you have to take down someone impressive and local to sell the reputation.
All right, let's... see what we want to do. Yeah, we're going to say make sure this works for sure.
You better know what you're doing, Brayden. Or what? You'll go find your own HUD contacts? Don't worry. I know the score here.
Found something. Check this out. Vex, Corellian. Champion quick draw artist, wanted for robbing 15 Imperial military pay stations.
Togawata Kiko Uba Kiriwata Buki Donko.
Perfect. This Vex is either a madman or a glory hound, and he's obviously dangerous.
Says here Vex has a safe house in the bad part of town, right in the heart of the madness. That'll be fun.
Nemro the Hutt's enemy took over part of this town. It's dangerous poking around in there, but it's your best shot. Raid Vex's safe house and look for something that might help us track him down, but be ready for anything.
Alrighty. Let's do... I'm ready.
Excuse me, but I have a safe house to shoot up.
Be safe out there.
Alright, there we go. So, we'll go ahead and start off with our bounty hunter, Lazy Link, here in the next episode that I'm going to be putting out shortly. So again, thank you for watching, and have a great rest of your evening, morning, or afternoon. Alright, take care. Bye-bye.